We're going to have a look in the car for what the riders need for refreshments.
Each rider will get two bottles, one with electrolytes and one with water. Each rider will have in the feed zone three gels of them, one with caffeine and one with orange and lemon. And then we have a little bottle of beetroot juice. It's something to recover already in the race. In total, we have 60 kilo of ice on the boxes. And during the race, we will buy some new. These are the feedbacks. Each rider will have one feedback. So we will put in all the stuff. Normally we prepare it before the race, but now it's too hot. Otherwise the energy bars will melt down. But now they are all in the cool box. But in the feed zone, just before the riders will come 10 minutes before, we will put everything in. And we provide them also with a panty, so a women sock with ice cubes in it. So they put it in the neck and then it melts down. So it's some refreshment for the riders.
Yeah, it was hot and it was 10% 4K straight uphill. And I managed to stay with the first till 1K. I think we were left with 7-8 guys, but then I exploded in the heat. And Robert came back and I could pull a little bit.
Went full gas uphill and to the max, and 10th, yeah, then must be happy with that, yeah.
Last 300 meter I was crawling to the finish. Actually, I was last 500 meters were not the best of the climb for me, but it's okay.
Today was the first really important stage where you can see what's the difference between the riders. Valverde, Quintana, Contador, Froome, if they are on the top level, they are really difficult to beat. And we are very close behind them with the three riders, so that's pretty good.
We improved then in general GC too, and maybe that's going to become a goal in the next stage.
Tomorrow, it's possible for a breakaway, but as a lot of times in cycling, it won't succeed, but there is a chance. It's a difficult, more difficult finish, but I think there are chances also for Paul Mattens, for example, when it comes to a sprint.